So I had a recent request about how I modded my Marlon and Rosie. So this is the team that I currently run him on, and it's a very offensive team. As you see, I leveled up his adrenaline rush, but I didn't touch his active skill because I don't really plan on using it, and I feel like it would be a waste of active trainers. I really like his rush and his honor roll skill. What I like about honor roll so much is that it's its own attack buff, meaning I can just focus on defense downing the opponent, and I can use basic attacks to a great amount of effectiveness. So I gave him an attack set mod set, so they're all attack based except for that attack up when taunted, but I think I can change that actually. So I have a pure attack mod on him in order to increase his attack, and then when honor roll gets going, it'll cause a higher percent of damage in the end. I added a attack versus fast trait just based on the teams that I usually use him against. I have an impair resist as well as a stun resist because honor roll can only be stopped if a toon is killed or if he becomes impaired or stunned. So by having both resists, it limits the number of times that honor roll will be nullified, even if I am unable to disarm a toon that has a stun gun or an impair weapon, or someone has an offensive stun on attack weapon that's green, or an on attack impair weapon, so either a blue one or that special yellow weapon. And the last mod that I have there is attack up when taunted, just because a lot of defensive teams have those toons that taunt and taunt and taunt. So I figure as long as he's not getting impaired or stunned, I may as well increase his basic attack, and that way he might be actually able to kill the toon that's taunting him. So I recently got an attack up when taunted mod in the attack set, and it leveled up really nicely, almost perfect, 20, 20, and 10. So 90% more attack. So I'm actually interested to know how this will affect him in matches overall, because I think he's going to be very strong. So I run Marlon and Rosie with a human shield. If I didn't, I might be tempted to do that attack graze set mod just so that he would have a higher chance of surviving. I can see AP drain also being a reasonable mod to use just because AP drain is almost useful on any toon. As soon as you're able to decrease the AP of the opponent, it prevents them from rushing as much, which is very important in a raid, in survival road, in war, in basically every aspect of the game itself. I would say you could definitely change out my attack versus fast mod and instead could do attack versus tough, alert, or strong. And again, if you don't have a human shield, you might want to do a defense versus a trait mod depending on what type of team you plan on using Marlon and Rosie against. Thank you for watching and listening to my video. I hope you found this to be informative.